Hello guys, my name is Amit Saini. Welcome to Study IQ. And in this PIV lesson, we are discussing important MCQs because the data on the PIV website, that is not much. And I am trying to help you here with the important current affairs section of the whole year. And we are taking important MCQs and important discussions regarding those areas. So these are going to help you a lot. And do not miss these lessons. In the evening, these lessons are coming in both Hindi and English language. And in the morning, the Hindu paper analysis videos, they come. So in both these lessons, MCQs are there. So we are discussing them. Before that, these are the numbers. There you can call and you can ask for these pendrive courses on the chat section available on this website. You can ask any of your queries regarding these courses. All are updated one and created by experts. 60% off is also going on. So these are very important courses. Now, the final MBBS examination will be held as common exam throughout country. That is correct. It will serve as exit test to be called a national exit test. This provision is correct according to the new National Medical Commission Bill. That is correct. Because they want to test that whether they have done MBBS with the utmost sincerity, and they won't need any other test to give them the license for practicing and all. So that would be important. Next, the maximum limit of 40% seats where they are regulated by the government, their pricing and all. So that number has been increased to 50%. It is not 75%. This is wrong. So the second statement is wrong and first is correct. Because now half of these seats, they will be regulated by the government in these private medical institutions. So that's important. So only one is the correct answer. Second is wrong. You can see here a provision of bridge course is also there. Means the state governments, they have given this discretion now that the problem is huge. Because for 10,000, 20,000, 30,000 people, there is no doctor in the rural areas. So the provision of one doctor per 1,000 people, that is recommended by WHO. That is nowhere a match in India. So state governments are now taking are going to take care of this issue in the primary healthcare sector. That is why this bridge course facilities will be available for the Ayush practitioners, and they will be able to write medicines just the normal MBBS doctors, they write about them. So they will practice like them, but they need to do this bridge course. Fee regulation and the participation in the National Medical Commission will rise for these representatives from states and union territories, and out of 25, 21 would be doctors. Means the professionalism they are bringing in the commission also, and a monetary penalty for the medical colleges if they are not following these norms and all, that would be applicable. And for the quacks, the people who are frauds, they are not actual doctors and they are running all these clinics or maybe some other facilities, so they will be punished. So the punishment is given here, and the financial the monetary punishment is also given in the provisions. Now this NMC bill will seek to replace the Medical Council of India that is existing now, and it will be replaced by National Medical Commission. So NMC would be there. That is why we're calling them NMC bill. Okay, and all these important issues, regulation of the medical education is going to be very, very important under this. Next, India at 75 document is released by Niti Aayog. You can see India at 75, these kind of idealistic phrases, they can be brought by the agency like Niti Aayog. So it is the National Institute for Transforming India. So this is India at 75, because in 2022, it would be 75 years since our independence. So drawing inspiration and direction from the Prime Minister's clarion call for establishing a new India by 2022. You see, they have shifted everything for 2022, and they are going to bring a new India by that year. So India at 75 document is taking care about all the issues of innovation, technology, enterprise, efficient management together, and all the implementation issues and all will be taken care of here. And detailed exposition across 41 crucial areas. So there are 41 chapters and 5 sections are there. Stakeholders, their numbers, they are going to rise. They all will be coming from central, state and district levels. And we have a target for our economy that it would rise to $5 trillion US dollars economy by 2030. So for that, we will take all the steps in this particular document, and that would be for 2022. Okay, you can see four important sections: drivers, infrastructures, inclusion and governance. So first section on drivers focuses on the engines of economic performance with chapters on growth, employment, doubling of farmers' income especially, and upgrading the science, technology, innovation ecosystem, and sunrise sectors like fintech and tourism. Sunrise means they are going to give a major boost to the economy, and very soon they are going to progress. So this is important. And second section on infrastructure deals with the physical foundation of growth, which are crucial to enhance competitiveness of Indian business, as also ensuring citizens' ease of living. So it is about ease of living, business, infrastructure, and the basics of economy. So that is the second section. And please read all the text, because in the prelims you will find something that is represented here. As you can see here, zero budget nature farming, that is going to be having a boost. A chapter on explore in India by revamping mineral exploration, licensing policy, rail development authority. So these kind of things are going to be highlights this year. And next section on inclusion, and it is talking about the healthcare sector inclusion and all these governance and skilling, everything is being talked here, because it is about the holistic inclusion. And next section on governance, so you must understand this, the BharatNet program, digital economy, and the digitization in the e-governance issue, and reform commission recommendations are also there. So they all will be implemented, and for that they are making this document, India at 75 by Niti Aayog. Next, Asia Competitiveness Institute is there, and that is in Singapore, and it has released an ease of doing business, that's a regional index, and it has evaluated 21 states of India. So Andhra Pradesh is actually at the top, Maharashtra is at second, and Delhi is at third number. So Andhra Pradesh actually has topped this list, and out of 21 states of India, Maharashtra second, Delhi would be third. It is based on three parameters called ABC, attractiveness, business friendliness, and competitiveness policies. So that is why index ABC. So remember that they will ask you that in which index the ABC section is important and which state is on the top. And it is by Singapore's Institute. Next, Fugitive Economic Offenders Bill, FEO Bill 2018. We know about Vijay Mallya, Nirav Modi, all are fugitive economic offenders now. And three ministries are involved here, Finance Ministry, Ministry of Corporate Affairs, and Information and Broadcasting Ministry. Now, according to this FEO Bill, this provides for confiscation of property upon a person being declared as an FEO. So this confiscation is actually an important provision here, because according to the CRPC 1973, after 2 years only you can take the property of that person who is declared as an FEO, but now you can take that immediately. So that is an important change here. Next, if the person is declared as an FEO, then the application will be filed not in High Court, it would be a special court, and it is going to be under the Prevention of Money Laundering Act, PMLA Act 2002. And according to its provision, where the amendments are being made here, then the application would be going into this fast track court, that is a special court under this act. So only one is the correct answer, second one is a wrong statement. Okay, it's a wrong statement, first is correct. You can see the money should be at least 100 crore rupees, and an arrest warrant has been issued against him for any specific offenses, then that person would be counted as FEO. So it is under the definition of it, and a special court is going to be there where the application would be filed under this PMLA Act. So this is going to be important, remember that PMLA Act of 2002, remember that. And the properties of the person may be confiscated and vested in the central government free of encumbrances, and further the FEO or any company associated with him may be barred from filing or defending civil claims. And that is also a controversial thing, because they are saying that you are violating the Article 21 here, but the government is very much stern on this, and they are saying that if you are taking money out of our economy and you are running away, not responding again, so you are one of the highest levels of criminals in India. So this is an important provision of confiscation of property, and it's a change from this CRPC 1973 provision. And this is the FEO's definition, and the person against whom an arrest warrant has been issued for committing an offense listed in schedule to the bill. Okay, so these are important provisions. Next, Hopman Cup is related with, it's a very special cup where mixed teams are there. At one side, males and females, and the other side, male and female. And tennis is the game with which it is associated to. Mixed competition with male and female players are on combined teams, and it was concluded on 5th of January. Annual international A team indoor hard court tennis tournament. You see, this word is very important, because there are different types of courts for tennis. The ground where they play, that is called court. So hard court tennis it is, and it was held in Perth, Western Australia. Okay, and Switzerland's Roger Federer and Belinda Bencic of the country is not given there. So they are the winners, and for the second time they are the winners. Okay, This year's tournament is the 31st edition of the Hopman Cup. And you see why this is important, because maybe this is the last edition here and it may be replaced by an ATP tournament from next year. So maybe there would not be any Hopman Cup from the next year. Next, Geeta Gopinath. Geeta Gopinath is associated with economy because she has been declared as the chief economist in IMF, International Monetary Fund. And what is the significance? In the balance of payment crisis, BOP crisis, IMF helps the countries, but with many conditions. Pakistan is trying to get this money from IMF, but many conditions would be there. We took a loan from IMF in 1991 and many conditions were there. Because of that, we needed to open our markets and we became a liberalized economy in 1991. So this is IMF, and here Geeta Gopinath is declared as the chief economist replacing Maurice Obstfeld. So that's very, very important and a proud moment. She hails from Mysore, Karnataka. Next, INS Kuhasa. We have heard about many INSs this year. INS Kolkata, Shakti. I told you Kolkata is a missile destroyer. Shakti is a replenishment ship. And they both are taking part in the International Fleet Review in China, Qingdao. And this INS Kuhasa is actually a new airbase in Andaman Nicobar Archipelago. And this is going to work as an important fourth air base of India and third naval air facility in this archipelago of Andaman and Nicobar. And it is northeast to Port Blair, means it's near to Andaman Islands. So strategically located in Andaman and Nicobar, and the Navy Chief inaugurated it on 24th of January. So that's important. And you see, this is going to be creating an important platform also for the future if there is going to be any kind of airport or something like that. So civilian traffic would be also allowed in some emergency conditions. Okay, so that's important. And you must remember that Andaman Nicobar is a very specific place. All kinds of vegetation from the tropical evergreen, the semi-evergreen, wet evergreen, and equatorial rainforest. Every kind of rich vegetation is there. And all our forces like military, navy and air force, they have their important bases in Andaman and Nicobar. Next, the Archaeological Survey of India, ASI, declared 6 monuments of national importance in 2018. And all are among this list, 6 lists. But one thing is there, this old High Court building is not in Pune, it is in Nagpur. Remember that. So this is wrong, and 2 and 3 is the correct answer. So B would be the correct answer here. The list is given here, 125-year-old old High Court building in Nagpur. In Agra, Haveli of Aga Khan, Hathi Khana, Neemrana Baudi is on Rajasthan's Alwar district. Neemrana is located on the NH8 when we are going from Delhi to Jaipur. And Vishnu Temple in Kotali, Pithoragarh, Uttarakhand. So that has become in this particular list of important monuments. And this is all for today. And we will meet again tomorrow. The PDF you will get here. Thanks a lot. Keep watching. And it was Amit Senif.